You ever studied hours for that exam only to show up on exam day and just not be where you want to be? Hi, I'm Dr. Blunt, and today I want to share with you a little bit about a strategy called retrieval practice that can help with that situation. Retrieval practice is the act of remembering something. Anytime you remember something, you're actually strengthening the memory for that idea. We often think of retrieval as a way of getting things out of your head, when in fact, retrieval is a really good way to get things in your head. We think that tests only are there to see what we know, but in fact, when we retrieve things, we're strengthening those memories. So today I want to share with you several different techniques, and I'll kind of walk alongside you and think how this might work in your life and in your classes as we kind of figure out how we can take this mindset shift and apply it to the things that you're learning. So how do we make the jump from thinking about cramming stuff in our head to thinking about retrieval as a powerful way to improve our learning? Let's think back to that exam moment. This is a common thing that happens when we see things over and over again, but we don't practice retrieval. For example, if I asked you to think about one of the most famous logos, the Apple logo, it's probably easy for you to recognize something like that. And yet, if I ask you to draw the Apple logo from memory, to retrieve the Apple logo like you would on an exam, it turns out only 1 in 85 students can do that. Similarly, what does a penny look like? You can spot it from 25 feet away. In my classrooms, I hold up a penny and everyone instantly recognizes it. And yet, 2/3 of students draw Lincoln facing the wrong way. Oh, what's going on here? What's happening is that we're using something or we're looking at something over and over again. That is, we're essentially doing something similar to rereading. And that's the strategy that people use the most. What I'm going to suggest is not to make a radical change, but to shift your mindset. Rather than rereading or focusing on a new strategy, take that material and recall it. So read the material once, cover it up, and from memory, what did I just read? So you've just read about the Krebs cycle. Rather than going through it again, cover it up, close that book, turn away if you need. What did I read? I'm closing my eyes because you may need to force yourself to do something so that you're not just rereading the book. Suppose you love a technique like concept mapping. It's a very popular technique in education, and it's a really good idea. It has different concepts, how they relate, and you connect them with linking words that connect these concepts together. Great. If you like concept mapping, keep concept mapping. However, add the twist that we're talking about. It's all about using that process of retrieval. Cover up your notes, then make your concept map. Another technique that people like to use a lot is highlighting. And we know that highlighting is not an effective technique. If you find yourself doing things like rereading your notes and highlighting, you probably find yourself in that situation where you show up for the exam and you just don't know the answers. What worked for you in high school, you may find, is no longer working for you at the next level. So instead, let's put this lens of retrieval on the activity of highlighting. What is it that you're doing when you're highlighting? Well, instead, let's think of, okay, I'm highlighting because I want to remember this. Well, let's just remember it then. let's skip the part where we highlight and close the material and say, what were the 3 main points in that paragraph? And if you'd like, you can do this in your head. If you need a little more discipline, you can write it down on paper. You can write it in the margins of your notes. Often what we see when people highlight is they tend to just end up highlighting the whole paragraph, which is not really helpful. One strategy that you can use is to use flashcards. Again, these strategies are things that you might already be doing, but we're going to think about how we can put the retrieval lens on them to make them even better. So for example, with flashcards, the temptation is often to take what we write something down, we flip at it and say, oh yeah, I kind of got that, and we put it in the done pile. Instead, what we need to do is we need to remember that it's the process of remembering that is so powerful for learning. So it's the process of thinking, what is that term? And then flipping over and reading the definition only after you have attempted to retrieve it once. In addition, you want to do this at least 3 times before you put it in the done pile. Retrieving it once isn't enough to be successful on the exam. If you can retrieve it once, that's okay, but we really want to aim for like 3 different times. Another technique you can use is a whiteboard. So you can take a whiteboard and just use it to retrieve and erase and retrieve and erase and keep repeating until you feel like you've mastered the concept. One thing to note about retrieval is, as I'm kind of thinking of that word feeling, it reminds me of sometimes how our feelings can lead us astray. We might think that we know something, but the only way to know for sure is to actually practice retrieval and see what you remember. In experiment after experiment that I have done, what I find is that techniques like rereading make you feel like you know it, whereas techniques like retrieval feel like, well, I don't really feel ready for the exam, but what happens is actually the opposite on exam day. So when you're using that whiteboard, in addition to getting the powerful benefits of remembering in and of itself from remembering, you're actually getting some judgments, some metacognitive benefits from knowing and seeing what you know and what you don't know. So if you're learning the Krebs cycle, what you can do is you can take the whiteboard and rather than just rereading about the Krebs cycle, draw it out. If you're a visual person, this is a great thing for you to do. You can retrieve with pictures. You can take images in your book and cover up the labels. If you're trying to learn anatomy, you can have a blank skeleton and use that skeleton to label all the different parts. You can use your whiteboard to list the cranial nerves, see how many you can remember. And only after you've really tried, then you can look back and see what you've gotten right. And again, once you can get all the cranial nerves, then you want to go back, repeat that a few times, and then you can move on. It's also helpful to mix up other subjects and not do these things back to back. Another way you can make this jump from thinking about just putting things in your head to thinking of retrieval as a powerful way to learn is you can make use of the resources that you already have. Often your textbooks will include sections that say check yourself or review, and there's already questions built into the textbook. So you don't have to reinvent the wheel. You don't have to make flashcards. You can just use the material that's already available to you. If there's not sections in your textbook along the way, you can look in the back and there's at least every textbook I've ever seen at least has a glossary section. And if you can look in that the dictionary part and see, do you know these terms? Write out the definitions, get that whiteboard out if you want. That's a way that you can use the resources that you already have to practice retrieval. In addition, you can use the headers of your textbook. So you can look in your book and there's often big sections that are in bold and different colors. You might cover that section up and say, what are the key concepts from this section? So again, you're using the prompts that are already there. You're not doing extra work. Retrieval is about thinking back and remembering. It's the process of remembering. So rather than rereading, we're taking the book, looking at the header, and identifying key concepts. Let me give you some other ideas that you might use for your classroom study. Some people come to me and say, Dr. Blunt, I'm a visual learner or I'm a kinetic learner. And a conversation on learning styles is a conversation for another day. However, the idea is, okay, what is it that you want to do? So suppose you want to learn about the brain by doing a sheep brain dissection, something we do in my neuroscience class. Great, good, do that. And I'm gonna challenge you to try that without the guide. So look at the brain, see if you can identify the parts, be hands-on, be visual, and do it without the notes. Once you've identified it without the notes, then you can go back before you make that incision and check that you actually have things correct. If you're someone who likes to draw pictures, great, draw pictures, just do it without the text. Another way you can be hands-on with retrieval is something I do in my neuroscience class. We learn about the brain, we learn about different parts of muscle, and we have models that we use. And students pass the models around, and we do this with each other. We call out different parts like sarcolemma, sarcomere, and the student points to it and tosses muscles around. It's a way that we can be hands-on, that we can be visual, And what matters is that we're practicing retrieval. Again, that process of remembering strengthens your memory. I can't say that enough. The process of remembering, that's what's strengthening your memories. Let's take another strategy that you've probably used before, practice tests. Your books sometimes have practice tests at the back. You might have a study guide with a practice test, or perhaps you're an athletic training student and you have the board certification test that you're studying for, or you're a med student getting ready to be board certified. A lot of these tests have practice tests, so you can prepare in advance. And you might be, again, thinking of this as an assessment to see how well prepared are you. Yes, that's true. And yet, the act of taking that test in and of itself is strengthening your memory for those concepts. So take that test, a practice retrieval. You will make mistakes along the way, but that's okay, because mistakes are part of how we learn. I hope that some of these applications have been helpful to you as you think about what retrieval might look like in your life. Again, at the end of the day, what matters is that you're thinking back to something and actively recalling rather than simply rereading. So as we end our time together, I invite you, think back, practice retrieval. What are the ways that you can transform your learning from this passive rereading to active retrieval? Thanks for sharing this time together.